In this video, we'll discuss about the physics of spring. Consider a block attached to a spring and resting on a smooth horizontal surface. As shown in the figure, this is the block and this is the spring. And the block is attached to the spring. You see, the block is attached to the spring and the spring and block system, they are on the smooth horizontal surface. This is the smooth horizontal surface. And the other end of the spring is attached to the rigid wall. This is a rigid wall. So this end of the spring, it is attached to the rigid wall. Suppose this spring is ideal spring. And for an ideal spring, we take the spring as massless. We suppose, imagine that the mass of the spring is negligible. And this is the equilibrium position of the spring. When x is equal to 0, we say it as equilibrium position. So when x equal to 0, that is the displacement of the spring is equal to 0, the spring is in equilibrium position. And in equilibrium position, there is no spring force. So at x equal to 0, spring force Fx is equal to 0. When x equal is greater than 0, that is displacement is positive, this side, if you displace this block to this side, then you can say that x is positive or displacement is positive. And you say the spring is stressed. In this condition, the spring is in stressed condition, and in stressed condition, the spring force Fx will act in the negative direction, in this direction. So the spring force Fs is negative, and when x is less than 0, as shown in the figure, here x is less than 0. The displacement is less than 0, and here the spring is compressed. You see how the spring is compressed, and in this case the spring force will be positive, that is in this direction. So when the spring is stressed, the spring force Fx is negative, and when the spring is compressed, the spring force Fs is positive. That is Fs greater than 0. So you have to remember these three conditions of spring. When displacement x equal to 0, the spring is in equilibrium position. When displacement x is positive, that is x greater than 0, the spring force Fs is negative. And when x is less than 0, that is spring is compressed, the spring force Fs is positive, that is Fs greater than 0. You have to remember the following points in spring force. The spring force is an example of a variable force which is conservative. You have to remember that the spring force is a variable force and also it is a conservative force. Point 2. The force law for the spring is called Hooke's law. And the spring force Fs is equal to minus of kx. Here k is called the spring constant. If the spring is stiff, then k is large. Or if k is large, then the spring will be stiff. And if k is small, then the spring will be soft. So for soft spring, k value is small. And for stiff spring, k value is large. And the unit of the spring constant K is Newton per meter. That is the unit of force is Newton. And unit of displacement X is meter. So the unit of force constant K is Newton per meter or Newton meter inverse. Third point, what is the work done by spring force? Now let us discuss about the work done by spring force. Suppose the maximum extension of the spring is equal to x m. Work done by the spring force, we write it W s, that is equal to integration of F s dx, because of spring force is a variable force, and for variable force work done can be written in this way, integration of F x dx from 0 to x m. And if you substitute the value of F s, that is equal to minus kx, then this will be equal to minus kx, integration of minus kx dx from 0 to x m, and its value will be equal to half k x m square. So you have to remember this thing, that work done by the spring force is negative. Always work done by spring force is negative, because it is always opposite to the direction of the displacement. But the work done by the external force, here the external force is the pulling force, so the work done by external force is opposite to the work done by the spring force. So the work done by the external force will be positive. You have to remember that the work done by spring force is negative, but the work done by the external force is positive. Why work done by the spring force is negative? Because work done by spring force is negative because Fs and x, that is the spring force and displacement, are in opposite sign. Suppose x is the maximum compression of the spring, so what will be the work done by the spring force? Ws will be equal to Fs dx, integration of Fs dx, and from 0 to xc. And if you calculate the work done by substituting Fs is equal to minus kx dx, then it will be equal to half k x c square. So you see, in case of compression also, the work done by the spring force will be negative. If a block is moved from an initial displacement, suppose x I, to a final displacement, let us say x f, then what will be the work done? Here the limits of integration will be from x I to x f, and the work done will be equal to half k x I square minus half k x f square. If the block is pulled from the initial position x I and allowed to return to the same initial position x I, then work done by the spring force will be equal to zero. If you take the integration of the force f s dx from x I to x I, initial to the final, that is again the initial point, then the work done will be equal to zero. Thus, work done by the spring force in a cyclic process will be equal to zero. And we know for conservative force, the work done by the force in the cyclic process is zero. And since spring force is a conservative force, the work done by the spring force in a cyclic process will be equal to zero. Next, we'll calculate. Next, we'll discuss the work done by spring force by considering area of the triangle. If we plot a graph taking displacement x along, suppose x-axis here, and the spring force along y-axis, then the area under this graph, that is x fx graph, will give you the work done by the spring force. As you see, suppose here we have taken the stretching of the spring. So in stretching of the spring, the displacement will be positive and the spring force, that is fx, will be negative. This side, negative y direction. So this graph, since fs is proportional to x, the graph will be this type. Because if it is negative, so the fs versus x graph will be like this. And the work done can be calculated from the area of this triangle, because work done is equal to the area of the triangle, that is equal to half into base into height, and base is equal to xm, and height is equal to fs, that is equal to minus kx by multiplying half into base length into height, we can find out the area that is equal to minus half k xm square. So you can calculate the work done by considering the area of the triangle. That is, if we plot a graph x versus fs, the area of the shaded triangle as shown to you represents the work done by the spring force. Area is equal to half into base length into height. That is equal to half into xm into fx. Fs, that is the spring force. And if you substitute, the spring force is equal to minus k into xm. The area will be equal to half k into xm square. Now let us discuss about the potential energy of the spring, which we generally write Vx. In one dimension, we write it Vx. When the block and the spring system is in equilibrium position, as shown to you in the figure, that is x equal to 0, the potential energy of the spring Vx will be equal to 0. So this is the equilibrium position of the spring, where x equal to 0, and here potential energy of the spring will be equal to 0. And for the extension of the spring, that is when x is greater than 0, this is called the extension of the spring. You see, this is the extension of the spring. Or for the compression of the spring, if x is less than 0, as shown in the figure, here x is less than 0. So if x is less than 0, it is called the compression of the spring. If x is greater than 0, it is called the extension of the spring. If x is less than 0, it is called the compression of the spring. And for both extension of the spring and compression of the spring, the potential energy of the spring will be equal to Vx, that is equal to half k x square. So remember, the potential energy of the spring Vx is equal to 0 in equilibrium position, that is when x equal to 0, and for an extension of the spring, that is x greater than 0, or compression of the spring x less than 0, potential energy of the spring Vx will be equal to half k into x square. Why the potential energy will be equal to half into kx square? Because we know the work done by the spring is equal to minus half kx square. And we know the change in potential energy of a for a conservative force is equal to negative of the work done by the conservative force. That is delta V, and here the change in potential energy we have taken Vx, that is equal to minus of W. Since work done is equal to half into kx square, so work done, the potential energy of the spring will be equal to half kx square. Now let us discuss the mechanical energy of spring. If we plot a graph between the displacement of the spring versus energy, total energy of the spring, then the shape of the graph for potential energy will be parabolic. Similarly, the shape of the graph for the kinetic energy will be also parabolic, because the potential energy is given by the formula half kx square, and this is the equation of a parabola. Similarly, for the kinetic energy, the equation is k equal to half mv square. This is also the equation of a parabola. So for both the potential energy and the kinetic energy, the shape of the graph in case of spring will be parabolic. So as shown in this figure, if you plot a graph taking displacement along x axis and the energy along y axis, then the shape of the graph for the potential energy will be parabolic. You see, this is the parabolic graph for the potential energy, and this is the parabolic graph for the kinetic energy k, and the displacement is from minus xm to plus xm, that is maximum compression to maximum extension. From the graph, it is clear that the two energies are complementary. That is, when the kinetic energy increases, the potential energy decreases. You see, here the kinetic energy is increasing and the potential energy is decreasing. So, the two energies are complementary and vice versa. That is, when potential energy is decreasing, the kinetic energy is increasing. But at any arbitrary point x, the total mechanical energy is constant. Suppose at here, if you calculate the total energy, then if you add the kinetic energy plus the potential energy, then the total energy E will be equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy, that will be equal to constant. So you should remember these equations. The potential energy is half kx square and the kinetic energy is half mv square, and the shape of the graph for potential energy is parabolic, and the shape of the graph for kinetic energy is also parabolic, and the two energies are complementary. That is, when kinetic energy increases, potential energy decreases, and vice versa. At any arbitrary point x, the total energy remains constant. That is, the total energy E is equal to k plus v, and the total energy E is equal to half k x m square. This is from law of conservation of energy. That is, the total energy E equal to half k x m square. It is maximum. For maximum value of displacement, the energy what you get, that is suppose equal to half k x m square, that is equal to the kinetic energy plus the potential energy at any position x, that is equal to half k x square plus half m v square, where x lies between minus x m and plus x m. That is maximum compression to maximum extension. So during spring oscillation, applying conservation of mechanical energy at the equilibrium position, that is x equal to 0. You remember, x equal to 0 is the equilibrium position. So when the spring oscillates, it oscillates from maximum compression to maximum extension. And in between maximum compression and maximum extension, there is a equilibrium position x equal to 0 through which the spring oscillates. So at equilibrium position, that is x equal to 0, kinetic energy is maximum. So if the kinetic energy is maximum, you see from this equation, v will be equal to maximum, speed will be equal to maximum, and potential energy will be equal to 0, that is x equal to 0. So if you substitute x equal to 0 here, then kinetic energy will be maximum, and for maximum kinetic energy, you take v equal to vm. So half m vm square, here I have written half m vm square, that will be equal to half k x m square. So vm can be calculated. Vm will be equal to k divided by m square root into x m. So here vm is the maximum speed of the spring. And here the dimension of k by m is t to the power minus 2. So let us see whether this equation is dimensionally correct or not. We know f equal to minus kx. So ma equal to minus kx, because force is equal to mass into acceleration. So k by m will be equal to a by x, and its dimension will be equal to t to the power minus 2. And here you check that the dimension of k by m is also equal to t to the power minus 2. So this equation is dimensionally correct. So in this video, we have discussed some physics of the spring, which will be helpful to you in solving many problems. Thank you.